Hashi Delay. Today I'm going to show you how to make Pucha, or Tibetan butter tea. Very famous Tibetan beverage. I have here everything you need to make Tibetan tea. The tea, which is a dark brick tea. Looks like this. Unsalted butter. Himalayan crystal salt. And half and half. And water. That's the ingredients. Today I'm going to make a small amount of pucha, which will utilize 2 cups of water. And I will end up making 1 teapot. And now I will show you the method. So we have to begin by breaking off some of the tea. This tea is pretty soft. And putting in, say, the equivalent of about 2 tablespoons of dry tea in the cold water. And I'm going to bring that to the boil. Okay. Now the tea has boiled. It's come to a rolling boil and we've boiled it for about a minute. You'll be able to smell the strong aroma of the tea. And it's a dark color, kind of the color of, let's say, maybe a dark beer, actually. And you'll need a strainer and pour the tea. Strain the tea into a slightly larger pot. And here I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of Himalayan crystal salt. It's large crystals, so that amounts to a very good amount of salt. And 4 ounces of unsalted butter. Also, a little less than 1 cup of half and half. I'm going to put this pot over low flame. Okay, now the butter and milk, everything is dissolved, and this is the important step, is to actually aerate the tea so that it will keep working. Each time we do this, it blends the milk, butter and tea together. This is an alternative method to actually churning the tea. Tibetan tea churners are not that readily available. But I will show you, if you do happen to find one, have this plastic one that I've had for a really long time. And I think I got it through Tibet House. Maybe they still have them. In which case, instead of pouring it in and out of the pot, you can churn the tea this way. And that's the preferred method. These were formerly made out of bamboo or wood. And that's it. For your presentation, it's nice if you have a teapot to put it in. If you warm the pot beforehand, that's also good. Tibetan tea is very strong. It's a good idea to offer your guests a little bit to try first. It's an acquired taste. Some people absolutely love Tibetan tea. Some people absolutely cannot drink it no matter what. So, many tash delay. A long life, good health, and may this be a wonderful, prosperous year for everyone. Delicious. It is delicious. Very delicious. I love Tibetan tea.